is.
Okay. Well, hello, everybody. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Mackenzie, and I am one of youth group's 2019 high school seniors, but I'm technically a rising college freshman, but I haven't shared a few pills on my mom that I could. It doesn't matter. So, to just give you guys a rundown, I've been here since I was about 4 or 5. I've grown up in church, grown up in a Christian homeschool environment, and I was saved when I was about 6. So, nothing crazy. I wasn't on the streets like a drug addict. God comes out of nowhere. No, that wasn't it. I was in my room, probably thinking about horses. But Caitlin first asked me to share my testimony about a week ago, and I was like, no, that's not happening. But I went home and I thought about it, and God prompted me. He was like, well, maybe you should. Maybe somebody could benefit from this. But don't be dead sassy. But I wanted to share a little bit about my acceptance of Christ, my testimony, but not so much that, but more how God has been working in my life as I've grown as a Christian. So like I said, I was saved when I was 6. I was in my room. My mom basically said, do you want to accept Christ? I was like, sure. So I've been walking with the Lord ever since then. But my personal walk with the Lord was pretty stagnant, especially in the first couple years of middle school, 6th, 7th grade. I wasn't really reading my Bible. I was going to church. That was about it. Wasn't doing much other than that. And, you know, my foundation in my life was built on sand. My life circumstances, my own self-sufficiency, what I thought I was capable of. Turns out that doesn't work. And so it all really hit ahead in 2014. For those of you who don't know me, that summer, my parents sat my brother and I down and basically said, we're getting divorced. Life's going to change. You need to figure it out. We wanted to let you know. And for me, an awkward, I think it was 13 or 14 year old, that threw me for a loop. I hated change. I hated anything. I was the most rigid person ever. You change a picture on a wall, I'm like, why? It's bad. It's bad. And so through that, it was God kind of teaching me how to accept things, teaching me how to be kind. And one big area in my life that I need to work on that God knew was my pride. I've struggled with pride ever since I was young. Bad thoughts, bad things I've done, put other people down, make myself feel better. I mean, you name it, I've done it. Thought I was better, my self-confidence, you know, looks like one of those heart monitor thingies. And God was trying to teach me in that time of when my parents were separating and then eventually divorcing that I needed to let things go. And I needed to give him control because he's God and we're not. But I was very stubborn. It often felt like a game of tug of war in my life. I would say, God, I want this. And he would say, no, you can't have it. I have it. And I'd be like, give it back to me, even though I never had it. Kind of like when you take a toy away from a little kid and they're jumping and they're trying to catch the toy and they can't get it because they're small. You know? And that's what it felt like. I don't know if that's what it felt like for God, but that's what it felt like for me. And it also kind of reminds me of the story of Jonah. You know how God tells Jonah, go to Nineveh? And Jonah goes, no. Jonah goes and gets in a whale and tries to sail to Tarshish. That's what it felt like. That's basically like, no, God, I don't want your plan. I don't want what you have to say. Goodbye. And God decided that that was a no. God in his grace gave me mercy in all of that. And he prompted me to start reading my Bible. I started reading my Bible back when my parents first split. And I just started one chapter a day and prompted me to start listening to more worship music, prompted me to actually be active in my walk with the Lord and to grow and to know him more and more. And as we, you know, we did through and went through this, he was teaching me how much I needed him. How much my life was not mine, but it was his. Even, you know, growing up in a Christian environment, you hear that every day. You know, well, God is in charge of your life and you have it, and you think, okay, yeah. But then when it comes to a head and you come to a trial and you come to a part where you have to say, all right, God, I'm gonna let this go. I don't know how we're gonna get through this. I don't know how we're gonna pay for this. I don't know how I'm gonna make it. But I know you have a plan and he will come through. He's come through, many times in my life. And there's not one time I've prayed for help with my pride that he hasn't answered me. It's embarrassing and it hurts and it's painful. He's never failed to help me and to change me more to be like the person in Christ, to be more like Christ. And I know for everybody in our own walks look different, and I know it's very frustrating, you know, when you're up and down daily when you sin and when things don't go your way, but you have to know that that is all part of God's plan and all something he wants for you. And it's been almost 5 years next month since my parents separated and eventually divorced, and it's probably been one of the hardest things I've gone through, but I wouldn't change it for the world. I wouldn't know God like I do today. I wouldn't be as involved as I would today. You know, it would have been a very different story. I would have been somewhere else, not a good place. But I wanted to share with you really quickly, if you feel that your own walk with God is frustrating and it's hard and it doesn't feel like it's there, I would just encourage you to keep going, and to keep praying, and to keep talking and tell him, you know, this is what my day was like. It stuck. Or it was really good, you know. Or I don't understand why you're doing this, but I trust you. And if you pray for him, he will change you more like Christ. He will. He's done that in my life, and I pray that he does that in yours as well. And I wanted to share one quick verse at the end that I took forever to find in that YouVersion search app. That thing's terrible. I searched a Bible verse and it's something totally different. Like, how am I going to share this? I can't talk about something else. Okay. So, anyways, the verse I picked was 2 Corinthians 3:18. But we all, with unveiled face, beholding as in a mirror the glory of the Lord, are being transformed into the same image from glory to glory, just as from the Lord, the Spirit. Just the idea that God is working in your life. And don't forget that. You have to surrender it. And that is all I have to say. Thank you.